Anointing for signs and wonders. If you have a pen, please write down, because I'm going to be ministering under the unction of the Holy Ghost. Double portion anointing of the Holy Ghost. The truth of the matter is we are living in the last days, and we are living in the power era of the church. Without power, Pharaoh will not bow. It's only through the demonstration of the power of the Most High God that will cause Pharaoh to bow. And Christianity without power is a frustrated religion. You didn't hear me? Christianity without power is a frustrated religion. You are a product of power.
Amen.
That was what God gave to you. Let us make man in our own image and in our likeness. Let them have dominion. God gave you dominion over everything that he created. So you are a product of power. But it's unfortunate this day we are no more witnessing signs and wonders. And it's not because Jesus Christ is dead. Our God's power is still very, very potent. I'll quickly give you 6 reasons. It seems as if we are no more witnessing signs and wonders in many of our churches. The first one is because theology has replaced revelation. For people that don't know God, just send them, tell them go and do Bible and they open church. Business has started. We already have board of directors. And what is theology? Theology is simply the study of God through human mind. Theology is the study of God through human mind. And you can never understand God through human mind. Remember, when God was asking disciples, whom do men say that I am? Matthew 16:13. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Matthew 16:13. Whom do men say that I am? I, the Son of Man, I am. And they say, you are Elijah, you are this, you are that. Peter, in verse 17, Peter was rejoicing. So Peter, don't rejoice that you know me. The only reason you know me, it's because my Father revealed me. So without revelation, and if the theology is not backed by the Holy Ghost, it's in vain. You can never understand God with your mind. Your mind is too binary. So figure God out. So theology has killed us in these last days. That's all backed. That theology must be backed by the Holy Ghost. The second reason we are no more seeing the power we ought to see it is because psychology. If you study psychology, I'm not saying it's bad, please. Psychology and psychiatry have also replaced the philosophy, discernment of spirit. Psychology is the study of human mind and soul. Why psychiatry is the study of human psyche, and they've replaced discernment of spirit. Man-made programs has replaced the leading of the spirit. As much as some people now have program planned 2 to 3 years without consulting the Holy Spirit, what do you think? Planning. And they call it planning. What is it? Don't plan. But are you involving the Holy Spirit? And we're supposed to be in the dispensation of the Holy Spirit. How can it manifest when we are really grilling Him? The fourth reason we're no more seeing power the way we ought to see power. Because entertainment has replaced power. It's about entertainment now. By the latest equipment. By the best person. And And as a pastor, you have to make sure you are also always buying the bed so that the church must keep on. Mm. Mm. We are still living in the power era of the church. You notice this as this motivational speaking. As we place the message of the cross. Mm. I'm not saying motivational speaking is not good. It's good, at least it will inspire you. But if the inspiration is lacking, the Holy Spirit lacking, it can't touch your heart. Mm. That's why you see you can jump and scream for Monday and Sunday. For Monday you are going back to where you are coming from. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 10, verse 38. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Change our lives. Damage our ignorance, O Lord. How God anointed, I feel like we put somebody's name there. But that's what it's because he said, what I did, you also do. How God anointed Jesus Christ with the Holy Ghost. That's where many of us stop. The moment you start speaking in tongues, you think you have arrived. God said, how God anointed Jesus Christ with the Holy Ghost and with power. That was the anointing. That he went about doing good and healing all manner of sicknesses. Anointing. Somebody say anointing. In this last is the anointing because it's getting darker.
Yes.
Those that are wicked are getting more wicked.
Yeah.
Pastors are giving up.
Yeah.
Muslims are taking over churches. And the only way you can confront them is by power. Somebody say power.
Power.
So I'm going to quickly give you five definitions of anointing. Write it down. Because what you don't know, you cannot respect. What you don't respect, you cannot attract. What is it called anointing? Anointing is the outflow of the Holy Spirit through a human vessel. That means as the Lord of hosts lives, after this message, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Anointing is the outflow of the Holy Spirit through a human vessel. That's you. Secondly, anointing is God's method of equipping his people. Anointing is God's method of equipping his people for exploits. That means without anointing, no exploits. Third definition of the anointing. Thank you, Lord. I give you the praise. Anointing is the empowering of the Holy Ghost for a supernatural accomplishment. The anointing is the empowering. You have to be empowered. The empowering of the Holy Ghost for a supernatural accomplishment. Ministry is supernatural by nature, and you need a supernatural means to carry it out. No, you meet with mechanical, you struggle. Because it's supernatural. And God is a supernatural, but God is never natural. The Hebrew word for the word anointing is shemen. S-H-E-M-E-N. Shemen or shemen, whatever way it's Hebrew. I don't know how to speak it, but that's the way. You can speak in tongues and the Holy Ghost will give you the interpretation of how to pronounce it well. But it's S-H-E-M-E-A-N, shemen. What does shemen mean? It simply means body removing and yoke destroying power of God. Remember, that's why we sing that song. By the anointing, Jesus prays that you, by the Holy Ghost and power. This is, you guys are looking too spiritual now. God is moving his power again. That means there are some yoke that will not go. until you introduce the anointing. It's only what you know and you respect that you can attract. Let me even say someone or two things about this anointing, because it can be confusing at times. Anointing is more than a feeling. What is I feel the anointing? Anointing is a force. Acts of the Apostles chapter 2 verses 1 through 4. Acts of the Apostles chapter 2 verses 1 through 4. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I give you the praise. I'm just a yielded vessel. I'm just fronting on your behalf. When the day of Pentecost had fully come, they were all the same way we are together in one accord. And they were all together in one accord, verse 2. And suddenly, oh, somebody, I like this word suddenly, because that's going to be your middle name. Amen. As you are on your way home, it will happen to you.
Amen.
The Bible, you just see, the Bible said that you will hear that somebody went through so many problems. All of a sudden, the next thing that you hear is suddenly.
Amen.
That suddenly is about to happen to you.
Amen.
It's possible you have been looking for a miracle. Miracle is looking for you.
Amen.
Breakthrough is looking for you.
Amen.
Fruitfulness is looking for you.
Amen.
Abundance is looking for you.
Amen.
Success is looking for you.
Amen.
And they will locate you today.
Amen.
If you are the one, miracle will locate. Shout the loudest hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me tell you, you have to be shouting because they shout inside. And the devil hates when you shout. Because anytime you are shouting, the devil gets confused. And he's asking all the demons, does he know something that I don't know? Why is he trying to figure that out? God would have given you a word of escape. Somebody shout it, dangerous hallelujah!
When we play so, when we are watching soccer, where in the moment the score you go, what do we do?
Shout.
Basketball, LeBron James, once he dunks, we shout.
And I keep wondering, how come we can shout for ordinary mortal men? Is it because they scored a goal? Has God not scored a goal in your life?
Hallelujah!
Your nation has still not scored a goal in your life. Minister Daddy has still not scored a goal in your life. Marita has still not scored a goal in your life. Physically has still not scored a goal in your life. Why not stand to your feet and just give God a ridiculous shout? In the next 1 minute. You are shouting, you are making a statement to God. You are telling him you are my champion.
Yeah.
Then you are shouting, you are telling him you are my champion. That's why you are shouting. And nothing is a force. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing. You might not know that because you don't live in Houston.
Wow.
Go and ask them. Ask them about what happened in Houston. Whether it was feeling. And this is a force.
I remember in those days when the anointing came over me, I had a strange encounter with God. All of a sudden, my body was just shaking. My body shook for 1 year. And they carried me to different ministries. The prayer was not good.
Anytime somebody start playing any Christian music, I'll be strong to tell them to turn it off. Because my whole body. 1 year! Them and everything is a feeling. It's not a feeling, it's a force. Force!
So when you see people manifesting anyhow, please don't laugh. Holy Spirit moves in different dimensions. It can cause somebody to. It can cause another person. Don't say it's called the Holy Spirit too.
He moves the way he likes.
Yes!
Yes! Hallelujah!
The anointing is usually for a specific purpose. And who I'm looking at you after this prayer, after this power and luminous conference, God's going to anoint you because God is getting ready to do something special.
Amen.
Through you.
Amen.
How God anointed Jesus Christ with the Holy Ghost and with power that he went about is for a purpose. God doesn't just anoint you. So when you want to do something unique, something special, the chandler, then you want to get involved. In those days in Israel, nobody was made a king that was not anointed. King Saul was anointed. King David was anointed. King Solomon was anointed. And they were all kings. And the Bible says in Revelation chapter 1, verse 5 and 6, that you have been made a king and a priest unto God. So for you to reign and rule effectively, you must be anointed. So you need the anointing. You need it. This anointing can make, it can make the unknown to be known. That was what happened to Elijah. The Bible gave us the names of almost all the fathers of all the major prophets. Amos, the father of Isaiah. We talk about Buzai. But when it came to Elijah, the Bible just referred to him as Elijah, the Tishbite. And in Israel, it's a shame for your father's name not to be known. So his father was unknown. He must have been a drunk. But the moment they are not in grabbing him, they are not in made him to be known. You may not be known today. After this conference,
hallelujah,
as the Lord of hosts liveth, the anointing of God that makes you to carry the aroma of glory, aroma of his presence, aroma of his favor, it will fall on you. Yeah. If you live and shout amen 3 times with the voice of thunder. This anointing can turn a madman into a missionary.
Yes.
You think I'm joking? Go and ask the madman of Gadara.
Yeah.
The anointing grabbed him. The madman, a lunatic. And he became a missionary. This anointing can turn a mistake into a king. That's what happened to David. He said, in sin, in iniquity, did my parents conceive me. And the anointing grabbed him and turned him into a king.
Amen.
Turned him into a king. This anointing can turn a society's useless person into a kingdom finest. It can turn a drug addict into an evangelist.
Amen.
And that's supposed to be the portion of somebody. God's about to do something that, oh my God, I'm believing. Please show me Project Mark 16, verse 20. That's what God wants to do in the house. Mark 16, verse 20. Let's see what the Bible says. And they went after this conference, as you go about, this is what's going to happen to you. And they went out and preached everywhere, the Lord walking with them and confirming the words accomplished with signs and wonders. From today henceforth, as you are walking about, this is how signs will follow you. Wonders will follow you in the name of Jesus. If that's for you, shout a better amen. Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes. Acts of the Apostles 5, verse 12. That's another thing that will happen to you. Acts of the Apostles 5, 12. And through the hands of... No, read it again. When you are reading the Bible, you have to personalize it. And through the hands of... Aha! Many signs and wonders were done. Can you lift your hands towards heaven? Now, read that scripture again. 1, 2, 3. Let's go. So shall it be.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Oh, Jesus, thank you. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 14, verse 3. That's what's going to happen to you. I didn't come here to entertain. Therefore, they stayed there a long time. As you live here, you are going to start speaking boldly. You will speak boldly. They will wonder what happened to you. Because you just finished a dominion and power conference. So boldness has come.
Amen.
My God, I see somebody here that will walk in boldness.
Amen.
As a matter of fact, I'm looking at somebody here. I don't know who that person is. Oh my God. It's possible that before this conference, when people don't have resources enough, they work anyhow. Their work is not coordinated. Even when they are greeting people, hi. But the moment when it comes in, level changes. You start seeing them. And when they are not with you, someone like a guyish. As I'm speaking to you right now, within the next 2 weeks, there are at least 7 people here. Your level will change. The way you work will change. The way you talk will change. The way you dress will change. By the reason of the anointing. If you are that one, I want to see you walk majestically. Just walk in the next 1 minute. Just walk majestically. Heaven is taking a note of this day. Heaven is taking a note of this day. What you are doing does not make sense. But God knows how to make sense out of nonsense. God knows how to make sense out of nonsense. God knows how to make sense. You are making those things that be not as though they have already happened. But the reason of the anointing will come to pass. After this conference, that's what's going to happen to you. Your steps will change. You will talk different. In the name of the human be seated. Why am I having you do this? Because it happened to somebody. In 1 Samuel chapter 10, verse 6. 1 Samuel chapter 10, verse 6. 1 Samuel, look at what the Bible says. Then the Spirit of the Lord will come upon you. Who is the you? And you will prophesy with them. And you can have not at home, please. But if you read it there, he said, it turned him into another man. After this dominion and power conference, you shall be turned into a different person. Even your family members will be wondering what happened to you. But one thing they will know, that you have been with the Lord. The name of Jesus. Is it that? They are not so expensive. It's not free. There's a price to pay. What's the price? 1 Kings chapter 19. 1 Kings chapter 19. 19 through 21. 1 Kings chapter 19. Do I need to speak in tongues? You guys have been amazing now. So, he departed. That's Elijah. From there, this is only the one that caught the double portion. So what he did, if we do it, we also catch it. So he departed from there and found Elisha, the son of Shaphat. His father was so rich. Remember, Elijah's father was not known. He was a drunk. Who was plowing? This man's father was rich. He was working with his father's servants. Some of us, this is their age. You will leave the servant to be working, and you go and sit down. He was plowing. He was working with the 12 yoke of oxen before him. And he was with the 12. Can you imagine? He was messed up. Then Elijah passed by him and threw his mantle on him. And he left the oxen and ran after Elijah. Elijah's father was unknown. His father was so rich. He left everything. In other words, he burnt the bridge. He said, they followed him. He said, forward ever, backward never. Oh, you want the anointing? There's a price to pay. One, you must be diligent. And not just not for lazy people. Yes. There is urgency in the kingdom of God.
Amen.
This man was walking with servants. Oh, you want the anointing? Oh, you must love righteousness. And you must hate wickedness. Psalm 45 verse 7. Oh, thou lovest righteousness. And you hate iniquity. You hate wickedness. Therefore, God, your God, has anointed you with the oil of gladness more than your companion. Oh, you want the anointing? You must be committed. You must be dedicated to the things of God. Oh my God. During Pentecost, when the fire of the Holy Ghost fell upon them all, the Bible says it filled all the places. The Bible says it sat on each and every one of them. I see the same Holy Ghost sitting on your destiny, in the name of Jesus. Sitting on your finances, in the name of Jesus. Sitting on your pocket, on your checkbook, in the name of Jesus. Hey! Oh God, let your hand become my hand. When Moses was holding the rod, normally Moses' hand wouldn't have done anything. But the moment God's hand became Moses' hand, he was able to do something. Can you just stretch out your hands? Say, Father, let your hand become my hand. Let my hand become your hand. Let your legs become my legs. Let my legs become your leg. Can you stand to your feet, please? Lay your hand on your... Touch your eyes. If Ezekiel prophesied to dry bone, you think you can prophesy to your eyes. Say, my eyes! Say it as if you mean it. You are shouting as if somebody is holding your throat from shouting. Say, my eyes! My eyes! Hear the word of the Lord. Be open. Begin to see. See treasures of darkness and the hidden riches of secret places. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lift your 2 hands towards heaven. Prophesy to your hand. Say, my hands! My hands! My hands! Hear you the word of the Lord. The Lord will make all that you do from now on to prosper. In the name of Jesus. Take a look at your legs. Just look at your legs. Say, my legs! My legs! My legs! Hear you the word of the Lord. I command you legs. Legs of mine. Begin to carry me. Begin to carry me to where my blessings are. Where my prosperity is. In the name of Jesus. Lift your 2 hands towards heaven. Just open your mouth. Close your eyes. Look unto Jesus. Our God is same. Yesterday, today, and forevermore. If the fire came and it fell on all of them, if it's not falling on all of us, then that means God is partial. That means God is a racist. But God is not a racist. If he did it for them, he will do it for us. Just don't say a word. I want you to see Jesus with your spiritual eyes. See Jesus. See Jesus. See Jesus. Just see him. Just see him. Just see him. I told God this is a simple. I want to also speak the word and things will happen. Yes, my Father. Father, you are the one that commanded in Psalm 81 verse 10. He said, open your mouth. Feel it. Father, Lord, they've opened their mouth. They've opened their mouth. Authority is in our mouth. Life and death is in our mouth. Perhaps we believe with our heart, or we confess with our mouth. But unfortunately, we only believe, we don't confess. So while we are waiting on you,